I'm Scott.
And I'm Claire, and we're the Mix Duo. We've been playing four hands piano since we got married in 2013, and we prepared a very fun program for you today, and so we hope you'll enjoy it.
So our presentation this morning consists of various performances we did in the last about year and a half. The first piece was recorded in February just this year at Douglas College for their concert series. So because it was a public place, we had to wear masks and the hall was empty, but it was really a fun experience. The filmers did various angles which they switched around while we were playing, and they streamed it live for their students. So the piece is Autumn Leaves by Joseph Kozma. Joseph Kozma was a Hungarian Jewish composer who lived in the 1900s. He was famous as a film composer in the mid-century, and actually Autumn Leaves was written for a 1940s French film. So the variations that I wrote take Autumn Leaves and transform the music into various classical pieces. So you'll hear Autumn Leaves in the form of Tchaikovsky's first piano concerto, the Liebestraum No. 3 by Franz Liszt, the Blue Danube Waltz by Johann Strauss, Chopin's Revolutionary Etude, Brahms's Hungarian Dance No. 4, and finally two variations from Rachmaninoff's Paganini Rhapsody. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Next on our program is the Melody in F by Anton Rubinstein. Rubinstein was a Russian Jewish composer who lived in the 1800s, no relation to Arthur Rubinstein, the Polish pianist who lived in the 1900s. Anyway, the Melody in F was a very popular piece during its time. Today it's still known, but not as well known as it was before. We found a beautiful forehand arrangement of it. Originally it's for solo piano, and the way Rubinstein wrote it was the melody is always in the thumbs, so it's always in the middle voice. So in the forehand arrangement, the primo's left hand always has the melody. So it's, I guess, slightly easier to play in this format.
And this video was recorded in our home, and so I am behind the camera, so I hope you like the videography of it. My idea was, we got feedbacks before that people enjoyed watching close-up of what we do with our hands. So I have one angle that is showing what we're doing on the piano, and some other angles showing our faces, trying to make it a little more, I guess, cinematic in a way. Yeah, so hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
The next piece on our program is a fun little piece by French Jewish composer Darius Milhaud, and this is the Brasileira from his Scaramouche suite. And this was originally for two pianos, and the composer spent some time in Brazil and he really loved their music culture. So he wrote several pieces based on Brazilian music, and this is one of them. It's a very catchy, dance-like piece, and it's quite popular for many different instruments. This arrangement we found on YouTube. It's not published as far as we know, but we were able to contact the arranger and she sent us her score immediately. So in modern times, you can receive music from halfway across the world in 1 second.
And I just wanted to add one thing. This video was recorded last year in our previous home. And when the pandemic first started, when we had to kind of be more social distanced, everyone was required to stay at home. So we started this Stay Home with the Meeks concert series last year, where we streamed a live concert from our old place once a week. And so this was part of the concert, so I hope you enjoy.
Yeah, and we used to have a green screen, not in this new
place
yet.
So you'll see some very interesting visuals.
So next on our program is a much calmer piece. This is the slow movement of Felix Mendelssohn's Piano Concerto No. 1 in G minor. Mendelssohn was a Jewish German composer who lived in the 1800s. This work as a concerto is meant for piano and orchestra, but of course we can't have an orchestra in our house, and we can barely fit two pianos, so we found a four-hand, one-piano arrangement, and the music still sounds very beautiful. Thank you. Next, we have music by the Polish Jewish composer Moszkowski. He wrote a lot of music, but like Rubinstein, not much of it is played today. So we're happy to try to popularize some of his pieces. We chose two short and very charming pieces from two different sets of forehand music. On our program, this is the only music that was originally for forehands, and this composer wrote a lot of forehand music. So the first one is a waltz. It's ABA form. You'll hear a slower middle section. The second piece is a really fast, short, very short. It's about 1 minute long. We had a lot of fun learning it, and we hope to play it over and over, and we hope you enjoy it too. Next on our program is a piece of music by British Jewish composer Stanley Myers. This is the Cavatina, made famous by the movie Deer Hunter, but actually it was written 8 years earlier for a different movie called The Walking Stick, which is nowhere near as famous as The Deer Hunter. And this arrangement we found, I think, on a Japanese website, and it works very well for forehands. It's originally played by guitar soloist with an orchestra, but we hope you like this forehand version. ¶¶ Next on our program is Some Enchanted Evening from the musical South Pacific by Richard Rodgers. Rodgers was a Jewish-American composer who is really well known as a Broadway composer. He wrote over 900 songs. This arrangement was done by one of Claire's classmates, Edward Neiman, who is currently living in Australia. We played earlier his Nutcracker arrangements, which were really, really difficult and very intricate. This arrangement is slightly more simple, but it still has signs of a lot of virtuosic writing. And this piece wasn't published at the time we played it. We asked the composer, the arranger, directly for it, and he sent us a copy. And since then, he has published it. So we're happy to share this with you today. Oh, by the way, this video was a compilation of a tour we did, a Valentine's tour, where we played in 6 different locations. So I took sections from the music from all the different places and compiled them together into one video. So the music runs from beginning to end, but you'll see different locations throughout. Thank you. on our program is a piece similar to the Brasileira. So the composer, Arthur Benjamin, who is an Australian Jew, he traveled to Jamaica and he loved the culture and the music so much there, he wrote this Jamaican rumba. And apparently for the years after he published this piece and it became really famous, the Jamaican government would send him a case of rum every year because he made their country popular. And this was also filmed during our Stay Home series last year. Piece on our program is my own arrangement of Smoke Gets in Your Eyes by American Jewish composer Jerome Kern. This arrangement is entirely based on another arrangement I played years ago for piano and two violins, and I remember I loved it so much at the time I learned it, so I wanted to revisit it at some point. So the opportunity came to arrange this for four-hands piano. And another reason is that our friend in Victoria told us that this is his favorite song, so we jumped at the opportunity to make an arrangement and perform it specially for him.